Rule 101 of racing in this apocalypse: bringing a ride that's ready for the end of all life. The Rustland Grand Prix introduces three new carts. Two of the carts can be earned in the Nitro Gauge and the other unlocked in the pit stop, and all of them are ready to take on the challenges of the wasteland. Earn enough Nitro in the Grand Prix to unlock a cart made from salvaged parts that is still capable of getting into a few scraps with your fellow racers. Keep collecting that Nitro, and you'll earn the other bonus cart, which is powered by a rotating chamber of pure nitrous and sports some mean-looking spikes. As for the new cart in the pit stop, it may not have any pointy spikes or an gnarly-looking grill, but this cart can fly, or hover, at least. With this cool retro-looking cart, you'll float like a butterfly, and sting like an apocalyptic warrior.
So this is what you've been up to in past month, Mango?
Gazzy, where did you come from? How did you get in? I'd specifically told my staff not to let anyone in for the sake of this quick review on Nitro Fuel's Rustland Grand Prix here.
One of your guards is a member of my Ferrari fan club.
The less we talk about Italian car brands, the sooner I can resume my quick thoughts on Rustland so that I can wrap up January 20th 20 as I'm prepping up a roadmap for next month too.
Well, since I'm here, Mango, how about a collaboration?
Either you take me to him, or you'll get a taste of what I have here, tucked away, locked and loaded to use on anyone now.
You're not the only one strapped around here, Suki Hops.
Dude, last time you was in my videos, you threatened Suki Hops. After that, I had to finish up any remaining side videos too. What makes you think I want to collaborate with you again?
I can help renew your PlayStation Plus since it expired.
Bruh.
You're so lucky, Dazzy. I'll go see what Skull is doing in the studio. You fill in the next segment of the review, and when I get back from the other room, I'll take over from here.
Even as the world comes is in ruins, the pit stop stands strong with new items for the Rustland Grand Prix. You'll find 8 costumes that channel an industrial punk style, including an absolutely rocking tiny, a half-crack half-metal dingodile, and a still adorable robot pura ready to be purchased with coins. Also available are paint jobs, new wheels, and stickers to make sure you have your ride ready for whatever's available. Need your car to have some grit and grime as you tear through Mega Mix Mania? Or perhaps you want to mark your territory with the new tag wheels that leave a trail of paint in their wake? The pit stop's got it all, and more. During this, some returning items from the spooky Grand Prix, as if Rustland got a bit scarier. So be on the lookout for some items that you may have missed from that spine-tingling event back in October too.
Which is why things change as nitro-fueled advances on.
NANI?!
Which is also why that I was burned out from playing this once I realized that these Grand Prix come and go on a monthly basis, even from Beenox and Activision themselves nowadays. Skull.
Oh really, Mr. Hitman, or is it Mr. Euro Truck Simulator?
Talk smack about what I play on my PS4, and you're gonna be on the receiving end of my assault rifle with bullets, Skull. And trust me, you really don't wanna go at it against me now.
You're not the only one strapped around here, Dazzy boy.
That's it, Skull. You're so gonna get your flank kicked.
Both of you, knock it off. I will have no bloodshed in my videos unless it against our enemies if the plot demands it.
In the meantime, I'm gonna head out. So long, suckers.
Okay, now that Dazzy is gone, Skull, mind finishing up so that I can prepare the latter half of Burning Rubber Season 2.
In addition to all the content that you can unlock either in the Nitro Gauge or Pit Stop this season, the Rustland Grand Prix features a few other items available. By winning some races with them, players will be able to earn Rustland variations of our two favorite newscasters, Chicken Stew. Plus, players will be able to have their country pride in with flag stickers for their carts. These stickers are unlocked automatically once the player has downloaded the game update for this Grand Prix. Those who rank among the top Rustland Grand Prix races in terms of victories or Nitro will also receive the champion cart, if you haven't earned it already, and it's livery based on a neocortex-inspired graffiti. So, what are you waiting for? Take on the world of Crash Team Racing nitro-fueled in the aftermath of the apocalypse in the Rustland Grand Prix, as we are at the halfway point too. With that, the quick review of Rustland is complete.
Thank Princess Twilight that it is, Skull. Now, I can focus less on major videos as I got my blog's pages ready.
Wait, you have a blogspot page, Mango. Why now though?
Let's just say that Inkpony wasn't working out for me, Skull. So, I went ahead and wrote a last minute journal there.
I see. Good thing you still got your Twitter and Discord.
Indeed. For now, it's time that I move onward and put out the release dates for the latter half of season 2. However, it can change, depending of my current status outside of work, so there's that, Skull. In the meantime, I'm Mango, and this is Burning Rubber.
I'm Skull, and see you all in February of 2020, everyone.
And I'm Dazzy, and I'll be around as always for you all.
Thanks for watching, and stay safe out there, viewers.